Or very commonly, will you inject my under eye? Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani and we're talking under eye. You know, we do a lot of trainings, both here at our clinic and around the country, different venues. And if I walk in, one of the first things I'll get is, hey, there's a patient we did their under eye and it just didn't look quite right. Can you look at them? Or can you teach us under eye? Or very commonly, will you inject my under eye? So it tells us that the under eye is delicate. It's difficult to inject. We need to know the anatomy. And I'm going to take you through what's one of the most common combinations and what people don't think of a lot. The temple needs to be addressed to me as part of the under eye for many patients because you need that lateral pull and also the sculptra that we use in the temple. Some of it gets around the under eye and helps with the crow's feet, which is part of the eye itself. So with the injections here in the temple, you can see we start above the zygomatic bone, and I'm using Sculptra, which is a liquid, of course. It's a water-based product that we hydrate. The PLLA, of course, doesn't hydrate because it's a polymer, but the other factors in the vial do. And when we inject it, we pull back on a water. We know, with all as possibly certainly as we can be, that we're not in a vessel. A gel, if you pull back on, you might get a flash of blood or not, but with a water, certainly it's not as viscous as a gel. And that's one of the reasons for using Sculptra in the temple. The others are that it's long lasting, you can massage it up and inject, get it posteriorly to get kind of that towel over the head pull back that patients love, that also helps with the under eye look. After we do that, sometimes we do high injection on the zygomatic of Sculptra, or like we're doing here, you can backfill a syringe with a hyaluronic acid that doesn't draw a lot of water in, cleanse the area, and then just do micro droplets along the periosteum, which is a safer layer than other layers for a couple reasons. One is, of course, there's less vasculature on the bone. You've got to make sure you know where the bone is so you're not through the orbital septum. And then the other reason is, even though it's a product that doesn't draw a lot of water in, as we're injecting it, it's going to bring water and maybe a little bit of bruising to the area. We don't want it to hold on to that water and give a baggy look to the under eye. Also, when patients travel and they're around humidity, hyaluronic acid can, after the fact, draw water in and have come back months later with a baggy looking under eye. So we're injecting along that periosteum level with the correct type of product. Now, the under eye can look good immediately because you're adding that gel filler, but we often add platelet-rich fibrin on top, or in this case, we did it a couple months before so that the skin is better, there's a little bit of fat plumping, and it hides the filler, even though we're putting it deeper. Everything we can do to hide the filler increases our chance of success because the number one reason the patients come back after under eye fillers is that it looks irregular, lumpy or bumpy, or baggy from drawing water in. So this helps us really prevent that problem. So the under eye, of course, it's complex. We're underneath the orbicularis oculi. We're using the right products. It's a combination procedure with not just HA, but also Sculptra, and sometimes other products like PRF, and knowing exactly what to tell the patient for their post-care. How do you inject the under eye? What's your favorite? Let us know below. Join us on Instagram, comment over there, and also here in this YouTube channel, and subscribe for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.